Welcome to the current lesson in which we will learn about positive and negative numbers. Now, this lesson is an introductory lesson for grade 6 mathematics students. The first thing that we need to understand when we are learning about positive and negative numbers is the number line. If you take a look at the image, this is the representation for a number line. A number line represents a sequence of numbers where we start from the origin, which is considered to be our starting point, which is the number zero. So zero is the place where we are going to start counting. This is the origin. This is the starting point. Now, we are familiar with counting numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so forth. So these are considered to be the positive numbers, which we are quite familiar with. When we are counting numbers, we are usually counting positive numbers, starting from 0 and working all the way to whatever number that we would like to reach, 100, 1,000, 10 million, irrespectively. But what's so special about this number line is, since we have clearly identified the point of origin, which is the zero point, and anything which is to the right of the zero point is considered to be positive. These are the positive numbers. We are going to add something new, which is the negative numbers. So how could we have a negative number? Well, this is quite simple. If we go below zero, we are going to go in the left direction. So in order to make sure that things are quite clear in that direction, we are going to say, since we have 1 on the right side, let's find the opposite, which is minus 1 on the left side. We have 2 on the right side. We're going to replace it with a minus 2 on the other side. 3, minus 3. 4, minus 4. 5, minus 5. So that way, we are able to complete another part behind the origin, which is the negative numbers or the negative integers. Now, this side, the one below zero, to the left side, this is where we have the negative numbers. And to the right of the zero, we are going to have the positive numbers. So let's replay what we have talked about. So we have a number line. This is what we call as a number line. And this number line, from the term number line, is a line that has numbers placed on it. Now, to order the numbers, we will start with the origin, which is the zero point. Then, once we go to the right of the origin, we are going to have positive numbers, such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now, once we go to the left of the origin, we said the right side we have positive. So if we go to the left side of the origin, how can we write the numbers? It's quite simple. Simply flip them. You have right on the right side, you have a positive 1. You're going to replace it with a negative 1. You got a positive 2. You are going to replace it with a negative 2. You got a positive 3, you are going to replace it with a negative 3. So the left side, which is considered behind the origin, we are going to place the negative numbers. So the right side we have positive, the left side we have negative. So what does that mean? How is this quite helpful? Well, the zero is considered the lowest number. So if we are going to count, usually we count from zero as to be the lowest. Let's say in this current case, we have 8 to be the highest, right? Lowest, which is zero, highest, which is 8 in this case. Since we have negative numbers which are below zero, these negative numbers, once we say the word below zero, it means anything with the negative sign is going to be lower than zero or less than zero. Negative numbers are always lower than zero. If you have minus one, is going to be less than zero. If you have minus two, is going to be less than zero. If you have minus three, is going to be less than zero. So let's write this down. If I have zero is more than minus one, zero is more than minus two, zero is more than minus three. Because zero is the starting point for the positive numbers, where we have one is more than zero, two is more than zero, three is more than zero. So positive numbers, all of them are going to be greater than zero. Negative numbers, since they are behind the zero, they are going to be less than zero. So for every number on the positive side, we are going to have a number on the negative side. So if I have one on the positive side, I'm going to have the opposite, which is minus one. If I'm going to have two on the positive side, I'm going to have minus two on the negative side. If I have three on the positive side, similarly, I'm going to have minus three on the negative side. So you notice, for every number which is positive, we are going to have an opposite number which is negative. The positive is always bigger than zero, and the negative is always less than zero. Let's have a couple practice problem. This is the number line that you are going to use to help you answer the following. We have example number one. Write down the opposite of the following numbers. Now, for every single problem, you are going to pause the video, try to do it by yourself, then you are going to write down the answer on a piece of paper, or you're going to write it on the comments, it's up to you, but try to do it on your own. So we have the following number, which is 3. What is the opposite of 3? We have 1. What is the opposite of 1? We have minus 2. What is the opposite of minus 2? We got minus 4. What is the opposite of minus 4? We got 5. What is the opposite of 5? And we got 6, or minus 6. What is the opposite of minus 6? So how do you do this? First of all, let's start with the first one. I'm going to locate 3. 3 is basically 3 places to the right of my origin. The opposite of 3 is going to be 3 places to the left of my origin. So we are going to have minus 3. Similarly, if we go for 1, the opposite of 1 is going to be minus 1. Let's try the other one in this case, which is minus 2. Now, minus 2 is located 2 spaces to the left of the origin. So what I'm going to do in this case, to find the opposite of minus 2, I'm going to go for 2 spaces to the right of the origin. So minus 2, the opposite of minus 2 is going to be 2. The opposite of minus 4 is going to be 4. The opposite of 5 is going to be minus 5. And the opposite of minus 6 is going to be 6. So what do you notice here? The opposite of a positive number is a negative number, and the opposite of a negative number is a positive number. So this is quite simple. Let's try to make it a bit more challenging, where we are going to compare between numbers. Compare the following, where we are going to state whether a number is larger or smaller than the other number. For example, I have -4 and 4. I have 0 and -1. And I have 1 and -2. And I have -2 and -4. Now let's take a look at the first one. -4 and 4. Now -4 is less than 0. And we said any negative number is going to be always less than 0. Compared to 4, 4 is greater than 0. So that means that 4 is the bigger number. Let's go for the other problem. How about 1 and -2? Always keep in mind that a positive number will always beat the negative number. So a positive number is always bigger than the negative number as a simple shortcut. So 1 is more than -2. How about 0? Is it considered to be -1? Well, 0 is considered to be the starting point of the positive and the starting point of the negative, but it's always higher than any negative number. Since if you take a look at the number line shows us that 0 is higher than -1. Think about it this way. If you count down, or count up in this case, -8, -7, -6, -5, -4, -3, -2, -1, then 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So obviously 0 is going to be more than -1. Now, how about the final problem? We do have -2 and -4. How do we go about this? Well, this is very simple. You can always use the number line. Take a look at the number line. We have -2 over here, and we got -4 over here. Which one is closer to 0? -2. So this means -2 is bigger than -4 because it's closer to the 0, which is considered to be higher than any negative number. There's another way to think about it. -2 and -4, if you compare them, which one is going to be more negative? -4 is obviously more negative. -4 is more negative than -2. So if it's more negative, it means it's smaller, since we use the word negative to represent something which is getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So once we say -4, it means we are way more negative than -2. So in this current case, -2 is bigger than -4. So let's recap the answers. 4 is bigger than -4. 1 is more than -2. 0 is more than -1. -2 is more than -4. So this mainly wraps it up for the current lesson on positive and negative numbers or integers, in which we have learned what is a number line. We said that the number line is a line which represents the positive and negative numbers, where the middle part or the origin is 0, which is in the middle of the number line. To the right of the number line, we have the positive numbers, and to the left of the number line, we have the negative numbers, where 0 is bigger than any negative number, and 0 is the starting point for both the positive and the negative. And to the left, we go in the negative direction. To the right, we go in the positive direction. The further we go to the right side, the higher the number. And obviously, any positive number is going to be bigger than any negative number. And once we draw a number line, we always pick a positive number and find the opposite of that number on the negative side. So this mainly sums it up for our current lesson on understanding the positive and negative numbers.